Hello everyone. In this lecture, I will explain you how we can implement single inheritance using C++. So before we implement single inheritance, I will let you know about the single inheritance. Single inheritance is the type of inheritance in which there will be only two classes. The first is base class and the second is derived class, and the derived class will inherit the property of base class. So for implementing this concept, we should have two classes. So first is base class. So for creating base class, we need to write keyword class. After that, I have to write class name, and this is the body of class. At present, I am writing nothing within this class, so the class has no member function and no data member. I am creating another class, that is derived class or child class. You can write any name. So the body of child class also blank, and here I will have to create main function, and in the main function I will create object of any of these classes. I can create object of base class and I can create object of child class also. So for implementing single inheritance, I need to inherit this base class in my child class. For this, I have to write the colon, and after that I have to write a access modifier here, like public, private and protected. I can write any one of these. So here I am writing only public access specifier, because I want from my base class that all the member of base class should become the public member of child class. So here I am creating a member function. So and this member function will print a message on the screen when I will call the show function. So the message is, this is my base class. I am creating another function within my child class. The name of the function is display, and it will print a message, this is my child class. So in the base class, the show function is by default private, so I'm not able to inherit this private member function, because when I'm trying to inherit it, it will become private for the child class also. So I won't be able to call it from outside the class. So for making show function, for accessing show function outside the class, I will have to keep it in the public area. So I will write here public access specifier, and I also want to call my display function outside the class. So I will keep it in the public area. Now in the main function, I will create object of the base class and derived class. So first I will create object of the base class, and in that case I will we will check which function will call. So I am creating base class object. For that I will have to write class name base. After that I have to write object name. So this is obj. Now I am creating obj is an object of base class. So now obj can call the function. So I will call obj dot show. I am calling show function by using obj objects. Now I will see what will be the output. So in this case, the output will be, this is my base class, because I am calling through obj, and obj is the function of base class, and base class has a function show. So in this case, show function will be called, and this is my base class message will be printed on the screen. So okay, my bad. Here I forget to use a call semicolon. So now I will run it again. So now the message I'm getting, the line 14, I'm getting a error. So we can see the output. This is my base class is the output of this program. And now if I want to use I want to call display function by using obj. So obj is belong to base class, and base class does not have display function. So in this case I will get an error. Okay, here you can see this class base has no member named display. For implementing drive class, so in drive class there are two functions available. First is show function and display function also. So if I create object of child class, so I can call display as well as show function. So first I'm calling display function, so I will get message, this is my child class. Here you can see this is my child class. And if I want to call show function, so show function is also available in drive class, because we have inherited all the properties of base class into drive class. So obj.show will display message, this is my base class. So this is the concept of single inheritance. So I hope you understood the concept. Thank you for watching this video.